Making your way in the world today takes everything you've got. Taking a break from all your worries sure would help a lot. Wouldn't you like to get away? Sometimes you wanna go where everybody knows your name, and they're always glad you came. You wanna be where you can see our troubles are all the same. You wanna be where everybody knows your name.
Good evening, good evening, good evening. How's everybody doing tonight? Welcome to Cardboard Happy Hour. I am your card tender for tonight, the card hobbyist. Hope you are all doing well. Ryan got in first on the chat. Jeff Airtime says second. Jeff Nichols in the house. What's up, Jeff Nickel? Stemmers, how you doing? PA's in the house. Cuz is in the house. Ron Figg's in the house. Says once a division in the blaster break. Michael Heath's in the house. What's up, Mike? Airtime also wants a division. Fester's in the house. Four Leaf. How you doing, Four Leaf? Goody G. Cornette Collection's in the house. What's up, Cornette? Mansman's also in the house. I think I got everybody. Breakers R Us just popped in. What's up, Breakers R Us? How's everybody doing tonight? Tonight's Fast Blast. Well, since Jeff's already bought in, Jeff's already claimed a division. It's a blaster full of minis. I mean, generally, it kind of is a blaster with a bunch of minis. It's 2020 Allen and Ginter. The non-sports cards will be randomed between all the breakers. It's $4 a division for 2020 A&G. So we got Fig, Airtime, and Jeff Nickel. Four Leaf. Fig, Airtime, Nickel, Four Leaf, and Mansman. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. One more. Ryan. Ryan's gonna take a spot. Okay. All right. That's full, folks. Could sell extra division for 9 cards. That's all good. I want some of that eclecticness to end up in the division for you divisional breakers. Not going to sell an extra spot for the non-sports. Man. Come on, Firefox. What's up with you? I need to check Firefox because, something's crashing it. Some kind of plugin or something, I guess. Sold out. Yes. Sold out. That is correct. What's up, TLM? How you doing? I just want a flat earth card. Saw Eggpool. You want a flat earth card? Still use Firefox? Actually, yes, I do use Firefox because Chrome, I don't know, there was like a memory leak in Chrome. And I even tried disabling all the extensions or plugins or whatever, and it was still just eating up memory like crazy. So I went to Firefox, which worked a little bit better till now. So browsers have just become giant resource hogs. I guess I should put that command into Nightbot Mansman. It's a good idea. So there's the website, Mansman. Four Leaf is super collecting the farm set. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. That's one of the things I love about A&G. Some people don't like it because they only want baseball cards, which is fine. But, like, there's always, like, something in there that piques your interest. You're like, oh, that's cool. Okay. Ryan's got 3 spots in the BBGB, 32. I think there's, not sure exactly how many are left. There's probably 8 spots left in the BBGB. Big says he loves A&G. Goody G says the farm set is funny. Hobbyist, I wanted the moon set from 2018. Let's see. Because I may be able to help you out a little bit with that. I used to collect A&G inserts. So, I still got quite a few. Let's see. No, that's 2013. Oh, I wasn't collecting in 2018. I wouldn't have the moon in 2018. But I did have quite a few A&G inserts from years past. Trying to see what I do have in there. That was from last year. If you like space cards, because I got some space cards from a set. It was called One Little Corner. It was from 2013. You know, you get stuff like Venus. And Eris. And however you say that. Ceres, Mercury, the asteroid belt, Uranus, giggity, Earth, and Mars. Yes, Joe, the break did go up to $8. And I actually, I have a Card Hobbyist Weekly coming out tomorrow. I explain why that is. I was messing with the ratios of packs in order to keep the price low. Just what I wanted to see, Uranus. Can never get by saying Uranus without a bunch of smart Alex chiming in. It's all good. My sister used to tell me nobody likes a smart ass. I said, it's always better than being a dumbass. You're gonna see Uranus again. Alright. No planet called Bob. Binge Cobra Kai on Sunday. I watched the first two episodes. It's a really cool show. I liked it. The first three episodes. It's really cool. From what I've seen so far. Now you have jokes coming out of Uranus. It never stops. In fact, in Mass Effect 2, you can go around and probe planets, like shoot probes at planets and find resources you can use to build, like, weapon mods and ship mods and stuff like that. Basically make your character stronger in Mass Effect 2. But you could also come to your own solar system, and you could shoot a probe at Uranus, and the computer says, really? When you do that, it's pretty funny. For at least now officially super collecting Uranus as well. Mike finished season 2. Alright. Let's see. PA says, can I become a mod? Well, I give one person a wrench a month. That's my rule. I give one person a wrench a month. And I usually do it by how often, you know, they're in the streams and stuff like that. I mean, look, Ron Figg's been with me since the start. Ron Figg doesn't even have a wrench yet. Let's take care of that. Ron Figg now has a wrench. Ron Figg, you are my October wrench. What's up, 101? Jeff Airtime bought a spot at BBGB. I think there was an error. It charged me $8. No, that is correct. The price went up, sir. We were just talking about that in chat. The price went up. I explained it tomorrow on my Card Hobbyist Weekly. So my Card Hobbyist Weekly will drop tomorrow. It's already uploaded. I just gotta make it public. Man. Come on, Firefox. What you doing? Goody G's birthday is October 3rd. Well, happy early birthday, because I'll probably forget. I'm terrible with birthdays. It says I better save my biddies. I explained it tomorrow, yeah. Past tense tomorrow. Danny! 12 again. What's up, Danny? Warcraft's in the house. Good to see you, Danny. Appreciate you stopping in, saying hi. I caught your A&G break today. Good to see you. Ron Fig, use that wrench. Don't sling that wrench around too much, Ron. What's your code? What do you mean, Chris? I sent you an email today. Check your emails. It isn't? All right. Let me see. Firefox probably didn't like it. Okay. Now is your name. Now do you have a wrench run? Oh, that's weird. Must be Firefox. Because I'm clicking add moderator. And it says, Ron Fig is now a moderator on your channel. But yet, you are not a mod. Warcraft, I think you do have... Yeah, you got like four cards in the stack over here. Test these 1, 2, 3. All right. We'll do this the old-fashioned way. Firefox doesn't want to be a bastardo. We'll go to YouTube Studio. Hope it doesn't crash on me. Let's see. Settings. Community. Moderators. Yeah, it's showing you on, it's showing you as a moderator on my, my back end in YouTube. The YouTube back end, so. Nah, it's not showing up in my chat either as him having a wrench yet, but it's showing you as a moderator in mine, so. I don't know, maybe there's something going on YouTube's end. Oh well. But you are a mod. Bastardo, yeah. I remember him. Pitcher. Oh, awesome to hear, Warcraft. Firefox is not a fan of Ron Fig. No, I think it's just YouTube. I think YouTube knows what's up. YouTube's got Ron Fig flagged. Like, that man cannot be a moderator on any channel. They got a black flag on Ron. Alright, let's get started with some cheapo cards. Started with some dimers. Alright. So, starting off with Brett Gardner. Let's get the Billy Hamilton right behind him. Let's get the focus right here. My nephew got in trouble at school for wearing a Bastardo jersey. Here's Billy Hamilton. You do troll a lot of non-sports channels. Joey Gallo. Hamilton sold to Ryan. There's Luis Castillo. Red's pitching staff's been really nice this year. Billy Hamilton to Ryan. Ryan, you are at 1340 coming into the night. That's without the shipping, of course. Ryan, and that's a dimer. All right, there's a second Billy Hamilton. Jose Uribe, Saber Stars, dupes of that. Bogart's opening day from 2018. Aaron Nola, Gypsy Queen. SMH goodie is Shake My Head. Taiwan Walker. Or Shaking My Head, however you want to read it. Another Taiwan Walker features now insert. Stanky Granky when he was on the Royals from 2006. And Sags getting big, you ship when you see fit. Yeah, I'll ship, Jeff. You got a $4 voucher. I'll ship as much as I can. The moon's bright outside. Kevin Kiermaier. Castillo. Got a Chuck Knoblauch hologram. I like the Tron background they got going on back there. The numbers of the GQs. Kiermaier is 27. Castillo is 249. That's 2020. And the Nola is 20, 2019. And the Castillo is 237 in 2019. You want both Castillos? All right. Going to Ryan. Nobby to Mansman. Joe, I got you at 4170. Stop being such a pain. I made $2 extra. Well, he paid $4 a while back. Where'd that knobber go? Where did knoblock go? Did I lose him? Oh, it's over here, camouflaged hologram cards. All right. Oh, Truth came in. Hey, what's up, Truth? Good to see you. I had a pretty good Tuesday. It was pretty nice. Got to see Danny do a RIP commercial or a RIP video today for like the first time in months. So you found Alan and Ginter. I found a box, but a kid grabbed the last box when I was at Walmart Saturday. Oh, really? I'm sure he would have gotten in trouble for Fukudome. We got Austin Meadows, Josh Donaldson, Bringer Rain. It's funny when he got ejected. Another Taiwan Walker. That's a dupe, ain't it? Must have three of those. Jared Parker. A couple of those. Mitch Haniger. Card number 143. Charlie Blackman, 2018. Bryce Brentz, rookie, 2015. Kepler, 2020. Gus says Big Spider. Be right back. Jared Parker. Some more Taiwan Walkers, but these are different. Different photo on them. Different card number too, probably. It just said stop keeping score. Bradley. Didi, 2018. Jackie Bradley, 2018 opening day. Adam Jones, 2015. Big Spider was only the size of a quarter. Did your kid say it was a big spider? Because, you know, when you're a kid, all spiders are gigantic. Andrelton Simmons, card 207 from Gypsy Queen. Edwin Diaz, Big League. Garlicle Smanders, 2018. Austin Meadows, 2019 Heritage. Jake Arrieta, card 31, 2019. Robbie Ray, Prism. Stanton sold to Jeff. Jeff, you owe negative money. You're in the credit. Max Muncy, Prism. Trevor Story, 2020. Dexter Fowler, 2020. TLM. I can't even pronounce that. Yonis Cespedes. Abreu. Patrick Corbin. Fowler sold to Ryan. Story sold to Airtime. Uranus is $2. Telling you, man, some of those insert sets, if you're able to build the whole insert set and sell it, you can get, like, I'm not going to say it's good money, but you can, like, it'll sell on eBay. Jay Bruce, I think back in, I haven't sold Allen and Ginter on eBay in forever, but I sold a complete insert set of, I think it was the Floating Fortresses insert set, which was, like, basically about, you know, gunships, like, sailing ships, old sailing ships, gunships, battleships, stuff like that. Here's a Rosario 2020. Like, it was a 20-card complete insert set, and I sold it for, like, I think it went for $13. It was from, like, 2012, Allen and Ginter. What's up, Ryan? Said best friend. That's awesome, right? I appreciate that. Jacob DeGrom. Why, Craig? Craig Kimbrell. Jake Arrieta. Yan Segura. DeGrom sold to Airtime. What's going on, Jeff? You jumping on the DeGrom bandwagon? Especially if he wins a third Cy Young in a war in a row. We got Kyle Schwarber. Jeff McNeil, Future Stars. JT Snow, score from 94. JT Snow. Rondell White, score from 94. I know that this is bright, but it's a Jim Abbott. JT sold to Goody. Understat Goody. TLM, Waxman. These are all Waxman's cards. Goody, you're at $4.90, sir. Coming in tonight. It's a dimer. He's almost as good as Lamet. Abbott sold to Mansman. Yeah, I mean, the Cy Young race in the NL is really close this year, but, like, I think DeGrom wins it just based on, you know, pedigree. He's already won it 2 years in a row. He's up there again, you know. I don't think he's blowing away the competition, you know, because there's a few pitchers that are having really great years. Future star Manny Ramirez from 94. You have 1,000. Gary Sheffield from 94. And a JT Snow Cup card from 94. If you have an ERA under 7, you're in the running. Manny sold to Mansman. So I got the Manny going to Mansman. Sheffield going to Ron. And Goody getting the snow. Snow on the Goody. And Sheffield going to Ron Fig. Ron, I'll search a new stack. Alrighty. Fingers crossed for Max to get the Cy. I mean, Max has had a really good season. He's up there, too. But I just think that DeGrom's pedigree, you know, the fact that, like, he's already won it twice, like, people are going to vote for that again. Yes, this is McNeil, Joe. I like how you can see that from the blurry picture. Airtime says Lamet's numbers are better. Like traditional numbers, like ERA and strikeouts and stuff. McNeil sold to Mansman. I haven't even looked at Lamet. I have not, like, kept up with stats or anything because I don't play fantasy baseball, so. And, like, the season's been so quick that I've really, like, haven't even really looked at the stats, you know. Somebody's having, like, a ridiculous breakout or something like that, like Voit hitting 20-something home runs. Yeah, it's a popularity vote, too. All right. Let's do some more dimers. All right. We got tomorrow's legends, Darren Erstad, Peraza, 2019, Kipnis Heritage, Jackson Stevens, rookie from 2018. Any Shane, I'm not Justin Bieber. J.A. Happ. I don't really have any Shane Bieber cards. One was in a repack on Sunday. Somebody got a Chrome Bieber in a repack on Sunday from Heritage. Kenley Jansen. John Lackey. Brett Butler, Stadium Club. Mark Grace, Bowman's Best. You got that Chrome Bieber, Jeff? Wait, did you get a repack this past Sunday? Pat Burrell, Tomorrow's Legends. Scout's Choice. No, I didn't even say who the player was. That is Gabe Kapler. Gabe Kapler. Sold Burrell to Goody. Can't count wins, Jeff. PA's back. Goody wants the Gabe as well. Gabe Kapler. Come on, Jeff. You can't go by wins. Scout's Choice, JD Drew. Jake Lamb, Gypsy Queen. Card 67. Salvi Perez Bowman from 2018. Bobby Bo Ricky. Gregory Polanco. Manny Machado 2019. PA wants the Bonilla. PA, I got you at $32.95 coming in tonight. Wins is the only stat that matters in sports. Yeah, but it matters, but it's not representative of a pitcher's skill, in my opinion. It's not a true measurement of a pitcher's skill. We play to win the game. Who was that? What's his name? Herm from the Jets. We got Sammy Sosa, MVP. JD Drew sold to Ryan. Herm Edwards, that was it. I couldn't think of his last name. We got a Rick Ankiel, Tomorrow's Legends. Brian Giles, Tomorrow's Legends. MVP Scout's Choice, Ben Grieve. Don't press send. Yeah. I can't say it like he said it. Buzztuve, Turkey Red. Carlos Santana, 2018. So Kikuchi still has a shot? And hey, you never know. He's pitched better this year, hasn't he? Than he did last year. Smoke, Prism. Familia, 2019. Knobloch, Stadium Club. Brady Anderson, rookie, 89. Travis Fryman, Stadium Club. They aren't legends today, they won't be legends tomorrow, exactly. We got Mitch Haniger. Kyle Gibson. J.A. Happ. Sold. Who? Gamaloa. Familia, okay. I'm like, Gamaloa, is that like one of Godzilla's foes in the old 70s movies? Gamaloa. All right, we got Paul O'Neill, score, 94. Gary Sheffield, 94, score. Fat Finger Syndrome, or is it Fast Finger Syndrome? John Olerud, 94, score. Raul Mondesi, 94, score. Not looking too pleased in that picture. Rick Ankiel sold. That was earlier, wasn't it? Here's Ankiel. Was he still a pitcher when this card came out? Yep. He was still a pitcher. Going to Ryan. Rick Ankiel. I give Ankiel this, man. That dude had a cannon in the outfield. Andy Van Slyke, 92 Donruss. John Olerud, 91 Ultra. Ruben Sierra, 91 Ultra. Gary Sheffield, 93 Tops. Jeff Conine, 93 Tops. Barry Zito, 2008 Tops. Connor Jackson, rookie, 2006 Tops. Brian Bannister, rookie, 2006 Tops. Olerud sold to Mansman. Donde está the Olerud? There it is. Got a mini Ankiel PC thanks to Essential Credentials. Sold Zito to Goody. Bannister to Mansman. Okay. We got a few of these Ames. I don't even know what Ames is. Ames 2020. These were printed by Topps. In 1989, they celebrated people that had 2020 seasons, at least, I guess. Ames, Eric Davis. Not sure what Ames is. When I grew up, I didn't even know what we didn't have Ames by us. I don't know if that was a grocery store or a drugstore. So y'all let me know. Gas station, maybe? If y'all had an Ames by you, let me know what it was. Just won a 72 Dave Kingman for 61 cents on eBay. Nice. Ames Daryl Strawberry. It was a department store. Ames Jokata. Did you have Zaire or Gold Circle? Like a store name? Those names in Warcraft? Strawberry going to Mansman. Kind of like a Kmart. Okay. Trying to think of department stores we had growing up. We had Kmart. South Florida, we had Kmart. Jefferson's. Of course, like Sears, you know, but that was countrywide. Woolworths. And then when I moved to Georgia, they had Roses here. Fester just said Roses, yeah. Brett Saberhagen, 90, Upper Deck. Yeah, they didn't have any Roses in Florida. But when I moved to Georgia, that's when I first saw Roses. It's also when I first saw Walmart. Because growing up, they didn't have Walmarts in South Florida. But when I moved to Georgia, it was the first time I saw Walmart. Juan Gonzalez. From Upper Deck, 94 Upper Deck. Juan Gun. Saberhagen sold to PA. Warcraft born South Florida. As was I. Remember seeing Piggly Wiggly for the first time in Tennessee. They had a Piggly Wiggly in South Florida when I was growing up. And Gary Sheffield, triple play. Gary Sheffield, triple play. Warner Park, okay. I'm from Miami. I was born in Miami. But I went to elementary school. Pretty much more of my years were spent in Fort Lauderdale than were in Miami. Any more Ames cards in here? I don't think there are. Because it says, be right back. There is a funny video that I must see. Alright. All the Ames going to Mansman. Ryan was born in Daytona Beach. Alright, so you're getting two more Ames cards, Joe. Joe says, be right back, coffee time. In fact, I'll be right back, too. I'm going to grab me a drink. So, give me a couple minutes, folks. I'm going to throw on some music. All right, folks, I'm back. That was quick. Just grab me a bottle of water real quick. Papa Pig? That's a video? Or Peppa Pig? Okay, Peppa Pig. I thought it said Papa Pig. We call it the pig where I'm from, because there's... Stupid Firefox, man. All right. All right, I switched over to Chrome because Firefox was being stupid. Let me know in chat if y'all can hear me because OBS looks like it's being stupid too. Hear you fine? Okay. All right, I'm going to reboot OBS, so you're going to get the spins here for a second, but I'm just going to reboot it because Firefox, like, crashed my OBS, too. All right. Should be good now. Hopefully. Unless Chrome decides it wants to crash, too. All right. Let's get some quarters. TLM says he's buffering still. Yeah, I had to shut down Streamlabs. five times WCW champion. I'm not sure I understand that one, Bradley. I'm not into wrestling. Alright, folks, we're going to start with Coda's. Got a Clay Buchholz mini die cut. Jacoby Ellsbury, Topstown. Freddie Freeman, 2019. Max Scherzer, Optique. Booker T's move was a spinnerini. Oh, really? Ender Inciarte, Future Stars, All-Star Game Stamp. Cole Hamels, Retro, 2017. This dude made out like a bandit this year. He pitched like four innings and got paid like $8 million. And now his season's done. Not bad for four innings, I guess. Bowman Birthdays, Max Kepler from Bowman Chrome. Might be a question on Sunday. Mark Trumbo, Big League Gold. Breakout Moments, James Shields. Stanky Granky, Topstown. Alan and Ginter Across the Years, Curtis Granderson. Never know. Team Franklin, Hunter Pence. Starlin Castro, 72 Design Mini. Granderson sold to Jeff Nickel. Jeff, I got you at $31.95 coming in tonight. Thank you, Jeff. Pence to Ryan. Ryan beat out Giddy. Ryan, do you want to give that one up to Giddy? Giddy PCs, Mr. Pence. I'm putting it in your stack for now, Ryan. Let me know if you want to let Giddy have that one. All right. All right, so you're going to hold on to it. We got Nolan Arenado, Optic. We got Jacoby Jones, Gold, Big League. We got Agon, Topstown. Breakout Moments, Luis Gonzalez. We got a Cargo, Die Cut, Mini, Carlos Gonzalez. Sold Selena Gomez. We haven't opened up A&G yet. I don't know if she's in that checklist. Shane Victorino, Saber Stars. Actually, a couple of those. Gonzo going to Jeff Nickel. Alrighty. Hold on one sec, guys. Just arranging some stuff here. Alright. Selena is reported to be the opening scene girl in Scream 5, which is filming now. They're making another Scream movie. Wow. Hanley Ramirez. This is a reprint. Burger's Best Hanley, reprint of a rookie card. We got a Kevin Kramer, rookie, last year. Hand Ram, is that what you call him, PA? Hand Ram? What's up, B-Pats? How you been? Good to see you. Thanks for stopping by. B-Pats cards. We got Chris Davis, Retro, Donruss. Remember, folks, I know YouTube doesn't make it easy to click on names. Or actually, they make it impossible because they don't allow you to do it. To click on names to sub to channels. But definitely, if you want to try to build up your sub list, definitely... paste your link into the chat, and I'm sure a mod will approve it. If not, I'll approve it. Francisco Cervelli, All-Star Game Stamp. Jacoby Ellsbury, Saber Stars. Just been chilling. Hey, can't beat that. A day chilling means a good day where nothing bad happened. Starling Marte. Alan Craig. Why, Craig? Airtime hooking up B-Patch channel and chat. We got the Queen's Throwbacks. Sunny Gray. Saber Stars, Joe Maurer. Roofnet Odor. Throwback. Retro. Yon Segura, Mini Die Cut. Got a couple of those. Chris Rowley, rookie. For the Blue Jays. Speaking of Blue Jays rookies, what was that rookie that debuted? I think it was last night for the Blue Jays. He kind of looks like Pablo Sandoval. He got that body type of Pablo Sandoval. He's really short and round. That dude's my hero. Because I'm short and round. We got Pedro Avila, rookie from 2019 Heritage. Javi Baez, 2019 update. Adam Jones, Die Cut Mini. Jaron Kendall, Bowman Scouts Top 100. Jaron Kendall. Is he related to Jason Kendall? Got the same initials. Michael Fulmer, Bowman. George Brett Retro, this year's Donruss. Got a couple of those. George Brett's. Got a Lewis Brinson. Anthony Rizzo. It's actually Lewis Brinson Refractor. Refractor. Adam Pac-Man Jones, two-sport athlete. There it is, Alejandro Kirk. He can hit two, decent catcher. Yeah, Alejandro Kirk, that dude's my hero. For short, round, short, overweight, round guys, playing baseball, smacking the ball, hitting home runs. Anthony Rizzo, legends in the making. So Jason Kendall's his father, Ryan? Nice. Brinson sold to PA. What's up, Smash? Doing well today. Thanks for stopping by. Appreciate it. Ben Intendi, Mother's Day. Buster Posey, Silver Slugger. Shohei Ohtani, Turkey Red. Eloy Jimenez, Turkey Red. TLM said Uranus sold Ohtani. So Posey going to Goody. Where would we put the Posey? Posey's going to Goody. One at a time, so we don't get mixed up. We got Ohtani going to TLM. TLM, let me find your stack. TLM, you're at 2660 coming into the night. And Ohtani is a quarter card. We got Eloy going to PA. Ryan wants all the mini cards that don't sell by the end. Okay. I'll do that for you, Ryan. All right. We got a Sean Murphy rated rookie. Ryan, you just made Jeff Airtime very, very happy. Are you haggling on a quarter card, PA? No haggle on a quarter card. Let's get these minis for Ryan. Ryan, do you want dupes of Yon Segura, or do you just want one? Let me know. You want both? Okay. Yeah, see? Airtime's happy. All the minis are disappearing from this stack. But don't worry, Airtime. There will always be more. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 minis. Going to Ryan. Thank you, Ryan. Don't tell me there's more where they came from. PA, I'm going to give you this Sean Murphy. You don't even have to give me 20 cents for it. I'm just going to hook you up with a Sean Murphy. Don't worry about it, PA. All right. Let's do some fitties. Get to some fitties. All right. All right, folks. Each of these cards will be fittiescent. We got all-time all-stars, Tom Glavin. We got Blake Snell. Diamond Kings. We got Kerry Wood, Curtin Cole, Hometown Heroes. At work, boss is gone, and I can't leave till I get the okay, so I'm getting paid to watch YouTube. Amen. There you go. Mark Trumbo, Rainbow Foil. Trumbo, Rainbow. What's up, Austin? How you doing tonight? As I forget to watch my latest video, great opportunity to win a great prize. Just have to be closest to how much you think I paid for a lot of cards. For your chance, looking at you. What, did I miss your last video, Bradley? Alright, I'll check it out. Bernie Williams. Rookie Bernie Williams. 90 Donruss. Jose Buztuve, postseason preeminence. Blue Parallel. Chris Sale, Optic, Diamond Kings. Colin McHugh, Gold, 2019. So many people live streaming right now. Yeah, that's every night, PA. The hobby YouTube is very, I say it's large, but like, really, the hobby, like as far as sports cards, is actually a very, very small niche on YouTube. It's a very small niche on YouTube. I think it might be smaller than the fishing niche. And it's way smaller than, like, the gaming niche or music or, you know, vlogging. Pretty wild. 3,000 Hits Club, Robin Yountu. CCB. Oh, CCB's on that. Tommy's Breaks, Comeback Card, Investor Striker. Yeah, Striker always streams on Tuesdays. Jorge Soler. Jose Urquidy, rookie. People who vlog should be slapped. I apologize ahead of time with BBGB. Right now, I'm unable to buy more in one spot. Oh, no, that's fine, Joe. That's fine. I understand that one bit. I'll watch my card obvious weekly tomorrow. Scoreless Streak, Kenta Maeda from Stadium Club. And I explain why I did it. And I'll explain, you know, in general terms why I did it right now. It went up because I was pretty much fudging the numbers. I wasn't fudging them, but I was manipulating the numbers in the pack picker game to keep that price below $650. You understand what I'm saying? So I was keeping the ratio of lower packs higher than the higher packs while keeping the average pack price low so that, you know, I can still keep selling the break cheaply. And it's gotten to a point where no matter what I buy, the price per pack has gone up. So, like, even in blasters, the price per pack has gone up. Because I think, I don't know if it was Tops or Tops Chrome. One of the Tops products this year had less packs this year in the blaster than they did before. So I was like, you know what? I'm tired of messing with the numbers, trying to keep the price at a certain point. I'm just going to let it roll. So this next break, if a bunch of hobby packs get pulled, or, you know, more of the more expensive packs, like even retail Bowman. I think retail Bowman was the one that you get one less pack than you did last year. But, like, even retail Bowman's close to $4 a pack when you're getting out of a blaster. It's pretty wild. Henry H. Mart, what's up, my friend? How you been? Kids' school clothes, wipe you out, yeah. That'll happen. Austin's hate for Nightbot still exists. Tim says, I think the dumbest thing on YouTube is dumb people doing dumb things. Yeah, but people watch dumb people doing dumb things. Austin said I only opened 3 boxes of Bowman this year. I've opened 2 packs of Bowman for myself. All right, we got Garlicle Smanders, Diamond Kings. Hope I didn't miss anybody buying something while I was running my lips. All right, we got Paul Molitor, 3,000 Hits Club. Kevin Pillar, Rainbow Foil. Aaron Savali, Rookie Retro from Donruss. Got 2 of those. Austin said I'll never like Nightbot. Mitch Haniger. Come on, Austin. My Nightbot has never timed you out on this channel. I don't think. Michael Fulmer. See, you're thinking back in the day when Deafness first put Nightbot on his channel and it was timing everybody out. Actually, yes. That's right, because I said my Nightbot never times anybody out and it got Austin. Austin figured out a way to get timed out. Keston Hira, Bowman from last year. We got Garlicle Smanders franchise feats. Even if you charge $12, we'll still buy from you cheapest around. Yeah, but I mean, I kind of enjoyed having it that cheap because it was like, there was no competition down at that price point for, you know, $6.50 for 2 teams. You know, there was no competition. It's not like I'm worried about competition. It was just, that was something that was like, that was mine, I guess, you know. I was the guy with the $6.50 where you get 2 teams. We got Nolan Arenado Glove Stories. We got Generation Now 28 doubles. David Wright hit 40 doubles that year. This one's number 28. I don't know what it was about card companies around this era, 2006, 2007, 2008, where they wanted a card for like every single double. They wanted a card for every single home run. Like the Mickey Mantle Home Run History insert set, which ran for 3 years. Right, soul demands, man. It was just weird that the card companies were doing that. And it wasn't just Topps, because Upper Deck did it too. I think Fleer had an insert set that was like that. It's like, why are y'all counting every single thing and putting a card to it? Just makes these huge insert sets. Hated the Mantle cards for every home run, Jervy Nuts. Yeah, right. We got Generation Now, David Wright, number 13. Generation Now, David Wright, number 4. Generation Now, David Wright, number 14. Generation Now, Justin Morneau, home run number 26. Love Mantle, but not those inserts. Am I here for your entertainment? Am I clown to you? Funny? Funny how? Like, I want to know, what makes me so funny? Funny how? Management's gonna take all the rights. All right. And I didn't say all right to be a pun. I just happened to say that. Tops Own the Game, Johan Santana. I always like this intro set. Own the Game. And Tops Own the Game, Carlos Beltran. Hey, Fig's Wrench works. Fig in the blue. Yeah, I guess it was Firefox. I did have to switch to Chrome. But I didn't make him a moderator in Chrome, so Firefox still worked. You got the wrench in Firefox. It just wasn't showing. Alright, so you want Beltran. Mansman's going to take the Beltran. If you can dodge a wrench, you can dodge a ball. What? Patches O'Houlihan. You know what's great about high school girls? I get older, they say the same age. All right, all right, all right. That is like the creepiest line of any movie, but it's a famous line. But I guarantee if you had a daughter in that high school, you wouldn't want that creep-ass dude hanging out. Austin says the luck of the Irish. All right, let's hide that. Let's holler for a dollar. When I was younger, we said that about Playboy Centerfold. The perviest line ever, right? Daughter just started at UNR. What's that? Reno? Is that Nevada, Reno? My job hired 3 high school girls for part-time work. I'm so glad I'm out of that place. All right, folks. Each of these will be a dollar. We got a Pank. Sean Murphy rookie. We got a Pank. Robel Garcia rookie, and we got a Pank Yu Chang rookie. Get the glare off of that one. Should we enhance? Enhance. Still kind of blurry. The enhance makes it blurry. Working for the media, I hear some interesting stuff. Quote, year from the lead sports writers of summer 2020, people love to read about COVID. One asks if there's a delay to the foosball season. Today is the anniversary of Willie Mays' 600 home run. All right, I'm going to take down Sean Murphy. We're going to put up an Eric Hosmer rainbow. I'm going to take down Robel Garcia. Put up a Benintendi sepia. Take down Yu Chang. And let's put up a Man Bear Puig insert. You know, Cuz was talking about spiders earlier. I think a spider bit me on my leg today. Ryan doesn't want anything to do with these. All right, we'll take Hosmer down. Put up a Castellanos 150 stamp. We'll take Benintendi down. We'll replace it with a Dustin Pedroia silver. We'll take Man Bear Puig. And replace it with a Mad Bum Marshalls, Diamond Marshalls silver. If you become Peter Parker's best friend, you're going to be suspicious. Mad Bum, sold to Goody. Replace that with a DK Originals insert, Bryce Harper. It's from 2015. Harper to TLM. I drove past Cave of the Winds when I visited Colorado and got worried we'd be eaten by Man Bear Pig. All right, let's put up another Harper from Diamond Kings Aficionado. We'll take Castellanos down. We'll put up Morneau. Allen and Ginter short print. TLM wants the other Harper. We'll put up a Clint Frazier die cut from Bowman Platinum. Sad that Harper was my favorite player for 5 years. Why is it sad, Austin? We'll take down the Pedroia silver. And put up a Noah Syndergaard purple. Bowman purple out of 250. Cave of the Wind sounds like Uranus. Because Harper backed up Snell. Bradley says because he went to Philadelphia. I'm surprised I pronounced that. Philadelphia. All right, let's take down Morneau. Let's put up a Joe Panic Gold from 2015. Gotta watch out for those winds of Uranus. We'll take down Clint Frazier. Speaking of Uranus, here's a Byung-ho Park. Panic sold. Goody. All right, cuz. Appreciate you hanging out. Have a good night. Ryan says Bryce Harper sucks. All right, we got a Mykal Givens short print from Heritage. TLM, do you really want the Bung Ho Park short print? Or are you just jiving? Yeah, that's what I figured. It's a clown question, bro. Alright, we got a Trevor Story Home Run Challenge card. Yeah, it's gold, so it's numbered out of 2015. Goody. The actual number on it is 1913 out of 2015. It's kind of hard to see. But it is numbered right there. Bryce Harper, I hate him. Sounds like a clickbait title. Bryce Harper, people hate him. Click here to find out why. Alright, we'll take down Syndergaard, and we'll put up a Josh Hamilton Emerald Super Rare Starquest. Take Givens down, short print. And the last card we got is a Carlos Quinton Black Ultra Rare Starquest. Yeah, Bryce Harper played some baseball. This happened. Alright, folks, I don't know if y'all heard my dog bark, but that's the signal is, and let me outside in the next 30 seconds or I'm going to piss on the rug. I'll be right back. Alright, I'm back now. Disaster averted. Austin's gone. Alright, Austin. Have a good night. You're still here. Ryan says I want the AL East. We shall see. When we break into A and G. See what happens next. All right. I'm going to pull up a rando. All right, I'm typing these divisions. If y'all are looking for cards to buy, it would be Vladdy right now. Because, like, his cards are low. Because, like, he wasn't all that great this year, I guess. But, like, his prices have been dropping. He's, like, old news. So, like, like, if you believe in Vladdy, like, turning into a good hitter or, like, a great player, now's the time to get his stuff. Bryce Harper asked him to sign an autograph. He says no. Oh, man, that sucks. All right. We got Ron Fig. We got Airtime. We got Jeff Nickel. We got Four Leaf. We got Mansman. And Ryan. Okay. So we can pull this up. Like this. There we go. All right. So we're going to randomize the divisions three times first. One, two, three. All right, NL East on top, NL Central on the bottom. And then breakers three times. One, two, three. Mansman on top, Airtime on the bottom. All right, let's hide this. There we go. There's the divisions. NL East, Joe Mansman, AL East, Ron Fig, AL Central, Four Leaf, NL West, Jeff Nickel, AL West, Ryan, and NL Central, Jeff Airtime. So, any trades want to be made, I'll give you all a minute to do that. Yeah, Mansman got the East. All right, Ron and Jeff are switching AL East for NL West. All right. So Jeff Nickel is going to get the AL East. And Ron Figg's going to get the NL West. All right, any other trades? Ron says, Dodgers come first. All right, last call for trades. My computer just put itself on airplane mode. Ryan is offering Jeff Nickel the AL West for the AL East. So, Jeff, you have a chance to swap out to the AL West if you'd like. I'll let y'all choose. You want me to cut it with the green dragon, or you want me to cut it with the red dragon? All right, Jeff Nickel is good with that trade. So let me do that real quick. So Jeff's going from the AL East to the AL West. Ryan is getting the AL East. Then, all right. AOS has been on fire. Last week, I know Airtime blew up the AOS one of the boxes. Anyone else want to trade? Jeff's just going to move around the whole major leagues. Jeff Nickel says Red Dragon. Any other preferences? Red Dragon, Green Dragon, Double Dragon. Bought two blasters, two cellos, three packs, and five jumbo packs A&G, and can't pull a darn gooden. Got two Lubobs, but no goodens. I'm sure you could flip a Lubob and get a gooden. Ron's asking every time he wants the D-packs. All right, Red Dragon it is. Good luck, everybody. Bradley says, Double Dragon. 2020 Allen and Ginter. This is the first of this I've been able to rip. Never said you were, Tim. I never said you were. All right. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And a bonus pack. Is that what you get? 8 packs in here? Okay. So let's get started. First pack. And remember, all the non-baseball cards will be random off between all participants. What I'll do is I'll just start with the first one, and we'll, like, the first one will go to Mansman, next non-sporter go to Ryan, and so far and so forth. So we got a Mike Trout starting off. I actually like the design on these. I like the, how it looks like you're looking at a pitcher, a little drop shadow here. Great design on these. Mike Trout. We got a Teft. Who's Teft? Stephen Teft, owner of 12 tattoos and body piercing in Groton, Connecticut. He tried out for the show Ink Master on Spike, then wound up winning the title season 2. Interesting. Tattoo artist. Send the Braves to Jeff Nickel. We'll do. We got Trevor Hoffman. We got Thune. Nick Thune. Comedian and actor. We got Long ball lore, Lou Gehrig. And we got a Thune regular size card. 7+1 bonus. You know the designer of the box can't count, right? So the Hoffman is a short print. I'll sleeve all these up at the end, unless we get something real nice. But what if it's a bowling or swimming technically a sport? That's why I said non-baseball. Non-doing with any of the teams in these divisions, Bradley. We're going to get technical. All right. Management says Green Dragon. A little late, man, Joe, on that one. We got Mike Schmidt. We got Friedman, pitching analyst. Larry Doby. We got Darren Erstad, A&G Beck, and a short print, number 304. Didn't know the focus was off this bad. Get the focus a little closer. Debut to remember, Johnny Cueto, and A-Rod. A-Rod. All right, next pack. We got a DJ LeMahieu. We got, who's this? Julian Edwards. Oh, he was in Bird Box. We got Gary Sheffield. Short print, I think. Scurry. Brianna Scurry, goalkeeper. A&G Beck. We got a Willis Tower. Willis Tower, formerly known as a Sears Tower. And a Ken Jeong. Ken Jeong. That's a cool card. Ken Jeong. Pitching analysis is baseball related. I didn't say baseball related. I said with these divisions. Bradley, you're just trying to be difficult here. How about this, Bradley? Non-former or current MLB players or managers. Like I said in my video of this product, I don't care for the non-baseball cards, but I like the design of the monster cards. Does Ken have autos? He might have autos in this. Usually when they have a celebrity on a card like that, they usually have an auto. Mike Mussina. Trevor Bauer. Donnie Baseball, Booming Cities, Dubai, Labradorite, Digging Deep. First found near Labrador, Canada, hence its name. And a Mike Fultonevich. Mike Fultonevich. Mike Fulton DFA. Tidy Whitey Relics, yeah, right? All right, you got Nick Ahmed. Nick Ahmed. Luis Arraez. Lou Brock. Hank Aaron Mini, very nice. Going to Jeff Nickel, courtesy of Joe. We got a pig. Nice. Down on the farm. Pig. The United States ranks third in pork production. Remember, guys, A&G give you an education. Jared Karabas, is that his name? Jared Karabas. I see him on Twitter. He's also with Barstool, I think. Tim says Ken does have an auto version. Nice. All right, three packs left, folks. I guess Jared go on the non-baseball player one. We got a Tommy Edman. We got a Jorge Alfaro. Duke Snyder. Atlanta Braves punch postseason. Nice. These are cool. The Where Monsters Lie. I might collect this insert set. Under the Bed. That's great artwork on there. And it's a pretty cool design, too. Where Monsters Hide Under the Bed. I like that little insert set. We got Joe Girardi, Field Generals, and a Nico Horner rookie. Nico Horner rookie. All right. Second to last pack, we got a Willie McCovey. Did you guys see Phil's pull open this and got a rip card? He opened it and pulled a base Hank Aaron mini. Was it a base? Or was it a wood? You got to check the numbering on the back. Because I don't think the rip cards have base minis in them. They have like short printed minis or something special like that. Oh, these are the ones you were talking about, Tim? Yeah, that's pretty cool. It's a cool little insert set. Willie McCovey. There's Shane, not Justin Bieber. Shout out to Bradley. He was asking about one earlier. Tony La Russa. We got Whale Shark, Behemoth Beneath. The Long Ball Lore, Eddie Matthews. Pretty cool. And a Brandon McKay rookie. It looked like base. I'll go back and see. Okay. Yeah, because I don't think they usually put base in rip cards. Because, like, the minis would be, like, the wood versions. Or the, they'd be numbered on the back. Like, hand numbered to 10 or something like that. Alright, we got a Devers. There's something glossy in here. We got a Blake Snell. Crack the Code. Little... Crack the Code. advertisement be the first to crack the code when special 20 and 20 Allen and Ginter code breaker autograph cards. Follow the code master on Twitter. I didn't know Allen and Ginter still did this. So every, y'all may not know this, but every Allen and Ginter has a code that if you figure out the code, you win special Allen and Ginter stuff. The fire has been put out. Tanks to ANG AOS not on fire. Yeah. Robin Yount, A&G back. Juan Marichal, debut to remember. And a Abraham Toro. So, oops, I put Robin Yount over here in the non-baseball. So that is the break, y'all. Not a whole lot going. There's quite a few inserts in here. A couple rookies, Nico, Brandon McKay. A lot of Hall of Famers. Lou Brock. It was a Donnie Baseball. A building. That needs to go over here. Overall, I really like the design of this set. Then we caught a trout. So the A&G West did catch a trout. It's always good to catch a trout. But yeah, I really like the design of A&G this year. Really nice set. I think I like it better than I did last year. Last year was pretty nice. And these are all the non-baseball player... or manager ones, Bradley Moore. These will be randomed. Darren Erstad's in there for some reason. Like I said, how I do it before, I'll just start on the list and everybody will get some. Get some of the non-baseballs. There was a Lou Brock in here. Big catch, or there was. I don't see Lou Brock in here. Yeah, Lou Brock was in the other pile. Bradley. Somewhere in there. But that'll do it for tonight, folks. I appreciate everybody that hung out tonight. Whether you bought cards or didn't buy cards, I really appreciate it. Always fun hanging out with y'all on Tuesdays and Thursday nights. Tomorrow, Card Hobbyist Weekly will be live. It's a longer video. It's about an hour long, mainly because I'm running my mouth a lot in it. I explained the price hike on BBGB. We got a mail day. Awesome mail day from TLM. Once again, thank you, TLM, for that. We got a production run estimation for Stadium Club. And a Fairfield break, like I always do. So, that'll do it for tonight. Goody G collects manager's cards. Nice. Oh, I found it. Okay, Bradley. So, yeah, that'll do it for the night. I'm going to go ahead and take off. I'll get these sorted. Ron, you have a package on the way to you. Stemmers, who I haven't seen in a while. Not sure if you're still in here. There's a package on the way to you. Yeah, and then BBGB 32 is continuing to fill. Should be filled by this weekend, and if it is, I'll send out an email and we'll break that again Sunday night. But until then, I will see you all Thursday. Check out the Card Hobbyist Weekly tomorrow. And, Tim says he's off tomorrow. I had time to watch it. You don't have to watch it all in one sitting, Tim. You know, it's a long video, an hour long. But yeah, appreciate y'all hanging out tonight. And I'll catch you all Thursday nights. Peace.